Okay, so today we're going to be talking about free Martin. So first off, we're just going to go through what a free Martin is. So free Martinism is a condition that occurs in cattle, which are normally not litter-bearing species. And this condition happens when a female is born twin to a male. So cattle, like I said, typically only have one calf per year. However, twins do occur about one in every 200 births. And of these births, about 50% of these sets contain both a heifer and bull calf, which is what you see in this picture here. So this is an example of a heifer and bull calf in utero together. So the problem with free Martinism is that the heifer and bull calf share a uterus, and the same placental membrane connects the fetuses to the dam. So this condition causes infertility in heifer calves about 90% of the time, and the bull calf is not affected. But sometimes there is reduced fertility due to a slight decrease in testes size. So next we're going to talk about the placental membrane connection, which is the real problem here that causes the heifer to be infertile. So they share the same placental membrane, which would not be the case with a litter-bearing species such as pigs, because each piglet would have its own amniotic sac. In cattle, the joining of the membrane between the two fetuses occurs around day 40 of gestation. And after this, the fluids are exchanged and mixed between the two calves. So in ruminants, they have a caudalitinary placenta. So there's numerous points of contact between the maternal and fetal vascular sides. So here's an example of that in sheep. So we're just going to go through like a review of the anatomy of that. So the caudalitin is the fetal side of the placenta. And then a carnuncle is the maternal side of the placenta. And then when those two joined, like you can see here, those together are called the placentome. So the placenta is responsible for nutrient exchange between the mother and fetus, gas exchange, removal of waste, filter and detoxification system. And it also produces a large amount of hormones, which is the problem. It also maintains temperature regulation and protects the growing fetus. But like I just said, the real problem is the hormone production here, because it occurs, the blood and antigen carrying characteristics are mixed and exchanged between the two fetuses. So the heifer and bull calf are gonna share different hormones. So next we're gonna go into what those hormones are. So blood chimerism, which is the presence of cells or blood from a different origin, occurs between the twins when the blood vessels in the chorion and torus become interconnected, which allows the passage of the male gonad determinants and hormones to the female twin. So you can see that in this picture here. And testicular development usually occurs before ovarian development in cattle. So hormones from the male pass to the female before development. One hormone that exchanges from the male to female is anti-Müllerian hormone, or AMH, and it's produced by the Sertoli cells of the testes. AMH inhibits growth and division of the Müllerian or fallopian tubes, which is also known as the paramesonephric ducts. This system persists and differentiates in the female to develop into the uterus part of the vagina, and thus the female internal sex organs will not fully develop in a heifer calf. The testes of the bull not only produce AMH, but they also produce androgens, predominantly testosterone, which when passed to the heifer, cause masculinization as well as the development of some male reproductive structures. So since the heifer calf is the only one really affected by this, we're going to talk about what happens to her. So the hormones AMH and testosterone cause the heifer that is twin to a bull calf to not develop properly in utero. So these hormones inhibit the growth of the female reproductive system and cause masculinization, like I just talked about in the last slide. So the resulting heifer calf is not only born sterile, but the female reproductive tract is usually not fully developed. For example, there's usually reduced development of the paramesonephric duct system, and sometimes development of the Wolfian or mesonephric duct system, which would normally be found in the male calf. She also usually has small ovaries, a short vagina, and reproductive tract, which you can see in this picture here, and no uterine body or cervix. The heifer will develop the Wolfian duct system if they undergo masculinization, and may also show signs of an epididymis, vas deferens, or vesicular glands, which would normally be found in the bull calf. And the heifer shows variation of its appearance in her external genitalia as well. So Often she could have an enlarged clitoris or a prominent tuft of hair on her vulva, which you can see in this picture. And these external signs would be a good way for a producer to kind of identify a free Martin heifer from the outside. And then finally, we're just gonna go through some fun facts. So free Martinism is most common in bovine species, but it's also been reported in species such as buffalo, goats, sheep, and even pigs. Most free Martins are born twin, but there are some cases where a single reared heifer calf can show free Martin characteristics. And usually in this case, the co-twin or the male was likely died or aborted in utero. There is no treatment for free Martinism. However, a diagnosis can be done using commercially developed probes to determine the length of the vagina, because in free Martins, the length is usually about 1/3 of the length of a normal developed heifer. However, it's not always accurate because they can have false negatives, as some free Martins will have a normal length reproductive tract. The probe is usually can be used to diagnose about 80% of free Martins, but if not, you can also do a polymerase chain reaction, which is a PCR, or blood typing, and those can be sent off to labs. Free Martin heifers have both XX and XY chromosomes, and around 86,000 of these are born annually in the dairy cattle industry in the United States. So, like I said earlier, just to wrap up, free Martinism occurs in 90% of heifers that are born twin to a bull calf, and these heifers shouldn't be kept around in production, even though occasionally they will show signs of heat, but they'll still be sterile.
And there's your references.
Yep.